Hi friends, myself Nagaya Siramat. I'm going to explain the part 3 of the microprocessor. That is, in the previous videos, I explained about introduction about microprocessor, then addressing modes, assembler, directives. In this video, the main objective of videos are control transfer instructions. I'm going to explain control transfer instructions, then stack operation. Transfer of control instructions. So how the control will be transferred? So based on condition or unconditional also, the control will be transferred to the particular memory locations. So based on conditions, we have conditional jump instructions. So if we look on to the conditional jump instructions, here I consider one example, that is JLE or JNG. Jump if less than or equal or jump if not greater. JNG stands for jump if not greater. JLE stands for jump if less than or equal. So what is the use of this JLE? Suppose if you are comparing some values either in the two register or one register to another memory location. For example, if you are comparing the values between the two register or the values between one register and memory location, then if you want to check the conditions, then we can go for the conditional jump instruction. That's why these instructions are used after the use of compare instruction. For example, compare BL, 39H. 39 is the immediate data and I have the register BL. So here this compare instruction, it compares the BL value with 39. If BL value is greater than of 39H, then I am checking for the condition JLE, jump if less than or equal. Suppose BL value is greater than this 39, then this condition it won't satisfy, it won't goes to next. Suppose if the BL value less than 39 or equals to 39, then JLE condition will be satisfied. The program control is transferred to the next. The next is the label that is given in the program. So that's the reason it is called as control of transfer instruction. Why it is control of transfer? Here we are transferring the program counter based on the conditions. Here control of transfer based on conditions, that's why it is called as conditional jump instruction. You can see one more example, compare BL, 39H. Again we are comparing BL value with 39H. Jump if not greater than. Suppose BL value is not greater than 39H, then go to next. The both conditions are same, JLE as well as JNG. But here it is conditional jump instruction is given as JNG. Jump if not greater. If BL value is not greater than 39H, then program control will goes to next. Otherwise, it goes to the next instruction. So we can see different conditional transfer instructions. JA slash JNB, jump if above or jump if not below or equal. These instructions used after the compare instruction. JAE, jump if above or equal or jump if not below. JB, jump if below slash jump if not above or equal slash jump if carry JC. So in this, some flags will be affect, carry flag and zero flag. This will affect JB, JNAE, JC will affect carry flag as well as zero flag. JBE slash JNA, jump if below or equal slash jump if not above. JE, JZ, jump if equal slash jump if zero. These are effects in the zero flag. JG, jump if greater. JNLE, jump if not less than nor equal. JGE, jump if greater or equal. JNL, jump if not less than. JL, jump if less than. JNGE, jump if not greater than or equal. JLE, jump if less than equal. Jump if not greater. JNC, jump if no carry. JNE, jump if not equal. JNZ, jump if not zero. JNO, jump if no overflow. JNP, jump if not parity. JPO, jump if parity odd. JNS, jump if not sign. JO, jump if overflow. JP, jump if parity. JPE, jump if parity even. JS, jump if sign flag. JCXZ, jump if CX is 0. We are checking CX value is 0 or not. JCXZ. So these are the conditional transfer instructions. These instructions are used after the compare instruction. Only these will used after the compare instruction to find the conditions. Next we have unconditional jump instructions. In that first one, JMP, jump. Then how to use this jump? The normal format of JMP instruction is JMP label. So that label is the address. So to that address, program control will be transferred without checking any conditions. That's why JMP is called as unconditional jump instructions. See here, this instruction will jump to the location specified in the instruction. So it will jump to that particular location as mentioned in the label. In that we have two types of jump, near jump and far jump. The near jump, if jump is takes place within the same segment, then that is called as near jump. If jump is takes place from one segment to another segment, suppose jump is takes place to the other segment, what we are executing jump instruction in the present segment, then that is called as far jump. Example, you can see JMP continue. What happens? The control will be transferred to the continue. Continue is written somewhere in the program. So program control directly jump to the continue label without checking any conditions in that present. So it is called as unconditional jump. Next, unconditional instructions call. So this call instruction is normally used in the procedure or subroutine program. It is used to transfer execution to a subroutine program or to a procedure. You are executing the main program, and if you want to call some subroutine or procedure, then we can use call instruction. In this call, we have two types of call, near call and far call. The near call, if you are calling the subroutine within the same segment, then that is called as near call. When you called call instruction, what happens? The stack pointer is decremented by two locations and it copies the offset of the next instruction after the call. So you are calling some subroutine program. After the call instruction, what you have, the code, that address will be written onto the stack by the push operation. How push operation will be done? First it will be decremented by two locations, then address will be copied onto the stack. That is the decremented by stack pointer by two and copies the offset of the next instruction after the call into the stack. The offset saved in the stack is referred to as the return address. Why we have to store that address in the stack? Because you are calling that procedure, the program control is transferred to the procedure, again you have to return back to the main program. So how it will return back? So whatever address is loaded in the stack, that is copied by the pop operation. So that is here, the near call instruction will also load the instruction pointer with the offset of the first instruction in the procedure. So to return back, we have to use RET instruction. At the end of the procedure, we'll return execution to the offset saved on the stack, which is copied back to the IP. So with the help of instruction pointer, the address will be loaded back to the IP and it will jumps to the main program. That is in the near call. Suppose if it is far call, how it will execute? See, if the procedure, you are calling procedure from the one segment to another segment, that is called as far call. In far call, So whatever instruction is there in the after the call, that address will be copied onto the stack. Here the code segment it will be content of the CS register address as well as IP address will be loaded onto the stack in case of far call. In case of near call, only IP address will be copied onto the stack. And to return back to the main program, so what happens, the again code segment address and IP address will load it back and it will jumps to the main program. Then one more instruction, that is unconditional jump instruction, that is RET. So whenever you are calling the subroutine or procedure, the program control will transfer to the procedure. So then how it will returns back to the main program? With the help of the RET instruction. The RET will be written in the at the end of the procedure. What happens, once RET instruction will execute, IP and CS register will loads the address of the main program instruction and it will jumps back to the jumps to that particular location. Then stack operation. The stack operation is normally done by two main operations, that is push operation and pop operation. Push in the sense we are writing data onto the stack segment. Pop, as the name indicates, pop, reading the data from the stack segment. So then how data will be write onto the stack? That writing and reading of the data from the stack segment done by 16-bit register, that is stack pointer. So if you want to write the data onto the stack segment, the stack pointer, it will be initially decremented by two location, then write the data onto the stack. In case of pop operation, first it will read the data from the stack segment, then it will be incremented by two location. Now we'll see how the stack pointer will reads and writes the data onto the stack segment. See, in this example, this is about push operation. I want to load the data of AX value and CX value onto the stack segment. So this is the stack segment memory location. Here is stack segment address is 3000H and stack pointer address is FFFFH. So in the earlier videos, we know that how to find out the physical address. The physical address for the stack segment, that is SS, is multiplied by 10H plus stack pointer address. So then you'll get the 20-bit physical address. So here 20-bit physical address 3FFFFH. Why it is 3FFH? 3000H is multiplied by 10S, so it will be 340s plus FF, so it will be 3FFFFH. Now your stack pointer is pointing in this location. So now you want to execute push AX operation. So once if you execute push AX operation, what is the value of push AX? 4455 is the lower value, 44 is the higher value. So your stack pointer initially it will be decremented by two locations. So this is one and this is two. So here it will be loaded as 55 and here it will be loaded as 44. See here, after execution, the stack pointer here 55 and 44 will be loaded. Then you are executing push CX. So again it will be decremented by two locations. Earlier it is stack pointer here, now it decremented by two locations. Then it will write the data onto the stack. First lower value is 34, 34 will be loaded. Next higher value 12, so 12. So what will happen in push operation, the stack pointer first initially it is decremented by 2, then it writes the data onto the stack. Next again you are calling pop push operation, again it will be decremented by, again it will loads the data. So in one operation, that is push operation, the stack pointer is decremented by 2, then writes the 16-bit data onto the stack. So that is push operation. Then pop operation. In this pop operation, the data will be read it from the stack segment. How it will be read? See here, the stack pointer is pointing, the address is FFFBH. So as I told, in case of pop operation, the stack pointer first it reads the data what is available in the stack segment, that will be loaded into the register, then it will be incremented by two locations. See here, 34 and 12. So first if you execute pop CX, so what will happen, CX will be loaded as 1234. So CX will be loaded as 1, 2, 3, 4, and stack pointer is incremented by 2 locations. Then it will point this location. So here it will point this location. Then what is that location? 55 and 44. So what is the data is available? 55, 44. Now I'm executing pop AX. What happens? AX will be loaded as 44, 55. 55 is the lower value, 55 lower, 44 is higher, 44 is higher. Then after reading the data from the stack segment, your stack pointer is incremented by 2. So your earlier address is 3FFFDH. Now your it is pointing to 3FFFH. So see here, after execution of pop, SP is pointing in this location. Before execution, SP is pointing here. How many times we executed? 2 times. Pop AX, pop CX, 2 times. In each time, 2 memory location will be incremented. So total 4. So it is 4 location is incremented here. Thank you for watching. If you like, share, subscribe, and also give comments.